Hey y'all, welcome to another episode of Tech Tuesday brought to you by Victory Archery. My name's Nate Watts. I'm the QC manager here at the company, and I'm here with
Jason Bensick, National Sales Manager.
All right, what's right around the corner? Like, we're on it right now.
Bugling bulls in September.
Heck yeah. All right, so Jason's from Idaho, grew up pounding the mountains up there, hunting elk. I'm from Wyoming, spent quite a bit of time in the mountains doing the same. So today we're gonna be talking about some arrows that we're gonna recommend for elk hunting. And just like the last time we talked about an antelope arrow, this is not the be all end all of anything. This is just some arrows that we've seen good results with. Just perform really well.
Yeah, like Nate said, this is a recommendation. I would say if you're looking to switch to the Victory brand, or you're just looking into getting into a new set of arrows or something like that, specifically for elk hunting, or just kind of like a do-all type shaft, then this would probably be our recommendation, like our highest recommendation. That doesn't go to say, like, if you're already shooting Victory branded products or whatever, that the standard VAP or the standard RIP or even the standard V-Force or a RIP XV or anything like that, those are gonna do the job. This would just be like a specific new setup for elk hunting
absolutely. And it's, I mean, every arrow is gonna do the job it's intended to do. A well-placed shot and an ethical shot is always gonna be the first thing, and first and foremost. Mm-hmm. And what we're going to talk about. Any arrow is going to do the job. But we've just seen good results with these specific arrows we've got sitting right here. And
right.
Definitely recommend these.
Yeah.
So first two we're going to talk about, micro diameter arrows.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll be talking about the VAP TKO and the VAP SS.
Yep.
Newest of the two is going to be the VAP SS. Predecessor to that was the VAP TKO, so this took our standard 166 platform and put our 3K weave on a 45 on this, mm-hmm. and what that generated was a very fast recovery and arrow on shot.
Mm-hmm.
So we're covered in about half the distance.
Spine uniformity is super tight on
these,
so that really helps with arrow flight, downrange accuracy, and penetration, because you don't lose kinetic energy there. Tolerances 1, 3, and 6, so super tight tolerances on these. So, cool looking arrow on top of that. I mean,
235, 300, 350, 400.
Yep.
And we're looking at some new spines. So yep. That's not gonna be the end of these. So yeah. Just keep your eye out.
Yeah, there'll be some new spines for 24.
So it's gonna come standard with a 50 grain shock TL, which is gonna be our two piece insert, plus or minus a thousandths on concentricity on that. And that's gonna be the standard insert. Optional 75 and 95 grain, yep. because you can't add weight to the back of a 166 insert.
Correct.
So we've got multiple options in there.
Yep, exactly. Exactly.
So VAP SS, so we took the TKO and kind of played with it and said, let's make a hybrid arrow. And that's what we did. So this is our stainless steel mesh infused with our 3K carbon. But the difference is the 3K is oriented at a 90 degree on this arrow. What that did is it actually brought the tolerances in really, really tight on this. Super tight spine uniformity and just a super durable arrow that is a true hybrid. So you've got a metal and a carbon combined in this. But if I flex this and let it go, it's not gonna stay bent. I'm not gonna sit there and have to try and straighten this thing back out or whatever. It's just gonna go back to the same straightness it was, which is gonna be a 1, 3, or 6 thousandths, mm-hmm. elite gamer sport.
Yep. And one reason too that we are choosing these specific arrows in the TKO and or the SS in VAP, RIP, and V-Force, because we also have a V-Force TKO here as well, is the micro 166 diameter, the small 204 diameter, you get better penetration with those, being a micro and or a small diameter. And then on top of that, with the TKO weave, the stainless steel mesh in the SS series, that also adds some weight and durability there too. So all these shafts are super durable. but they also are just a little bit more in GPI than our standard line. So you gain a little bit of weight there too. So that's another reason why we would recommend these for elk, you know, for larger elk type game and or.
Absolutely. And Jason just brought up penetration. So one thing that we need to point out is the inserts that come with these allow you to shoot a 5/16 point, meaning larger point is going to taper back to the diameter of the shaft. So making a bigger hole, smaller shaft going through the hole means more penetration, less right. friction, moving
drag
through an animal. So not going to be like some of the other components out there where it fits the diameter of the shaft. It actually tapers back to the diameter of the shaft, allowing you to shoot a larger point.
Right, exactly.
All right, small diameter.
Yeah, so we got here in the small diameter, which is going to be your 204 inside diameter shaft, is the RIP TKO. So much like the VAP TKO that we just talked about, this is basically it in a 204. It's got that 45 degree weave in the TKO materials, in our 3K weave materials. So if you're not wanting to look at going to that 166 micro diameter and you still want a small diameter, then this is going to be your choice here for sure. Spines in this is 250, 3, 350, and 4. And like we said before, we've got more spine selections coming in 2024 as well. So be on the lookout for those. Tolerances in this is, as far as straightness goes, is a 1, a 3, and a 6,000 straightness as well. And then this also has come standard with the 50 grain shock TL insert, much like the VAP TKO and the VAP SS, except the only difference with this is it is large enough to be able to thread all the way through. So then we can add
10, 20, and 50 grain back weight to this.
Yeah.
Just allows you to really play with your FOC on this arrow to really dial in the setup that you're looking for.
Mm-hmm. We do offer it in a 75 as well. So if you do want to jump up to that 75, get that hybrid stainless aluminum type shock TL for the RIP, you can do that and then add back weights there as well. Or you can just start at the 50 with the standard that it comes with.
Now, he brought up the stainless aluminum. So this is going to be a little bit more durable in the fact that it does have a stainless post instead of an aluminum post. But at the end of the day, the 50 grain aluminum is extremely strong as well.
We haven't had any issues really.
If an arrow is cut, prepped, trued up, and glued together correctly, you're not going to have any issues with that insert pulling out or just, you know, failing on you for no apparent reason.
Right. Yeah. Exactly. So next in the 204, just like the 166 that we went over with, is and this was new for this year, is the RIP SS. So it's that 90 degree weave layup on the 204 diameter with that stainless steel mesh that Nate was talking about earlier in the VAP SS. That's also infused, I guess you could say, into the center of the shaft. So same concept there. 204 diameter adds a little bit of weight and durability. You can flex that shaft and it will not take a set. It'll stay with its true concentricity that it's called out
how
at.
It was built.
Yep, exactly.
Yeah, when that thing came off the line, it was this straightness, and we measured it on lasers and said, yep, that's what it is, and it stays, that's what it stays.
Yep, yep. And spines on this is 250, 3, 350, 400 as well.
For now.
Most spines, for now, yeah. So same concept here as well with the shock TL insert. Comes with a standard 50 grain threaded through, so you can add back weights. You can get that 75 option with that like hybrid stainless steel post outer aluminum sleeve in the 75 grain, and then you can also add back weights to that. But this is another killer 204 shaft that we have that I would recommend.
And right now we're talking about shafts here, and I did want to bring up something. So on the TKO series arrows, you can get that in fletched, and that's going to come with a 2-inch HP style vane.
Mm-hmm.
And then on the SS series arrows, that's going to be a 2.1-inch shield cut fusion vein. So yeah, like it is going to have a different vein on there if you elect to get these fletched, and they'll be with a 2.5 degree right helical, fletched on a Bitzenberger jig, and we do all that in-house in our production facility. Last arrow.
Last but not least, V-Force TKO. Now, the reason why we chose this, obviously, is because it's in that TKO series, so you get that 45-degree 3K weave pattern that we have on all of our TKO series. It adds a little bit of weight, like we mentioned before, to like the standard V-Force build that we have in our lineup. The 245 diameter being pretty much the standard diameter across the board in the outdoor industry.
It's your meat and potatoes diameter.
Yeah, and this is basically like pretty much what everybody starts shooting in that 245 diameter. This is just kind of a beefed up series of it.
But keep in mind, it is beefed up, but the thing you'll notice if you shoot a standard V-Force to a V-Force TKO, is your drop is not going to be as significant as you think with the grain weight because it recovers faster on shot.
Correct. So, and a lot of guys like that standard diameter shaft. They've been shooting it for years. They don't want to move to a smaller or micro. It's just something that's been tried and true and works. So that's a standard diameter that I would recommend. It does come with a 22 grain insert that's also threaded all the way through, so we can add back weights to that for your FOC and get that up if you're looking at a little bit more FOC for downrange broadhead accuracy and penetration. Spines on this is 253, 350,
and
four. Do we have a five? No, we
not
don't.
Yet.
Not a five.
Not
in
yet.
This.
We're working on it.
Yeah, and then 1,000 straightness, 3,000 straightness, 6,000 straightness for tolerance.
And keep in mind, all of these arrows now are going to come with the AAE IP series knock on these as well. Just a super consistent knock. It's got just, you know, some beefier ears on
durable,
it. Throat consistency is just phenomenal on these. Mm-hmm. And release off string is consistent shot after shot, batch after batch.
Yep.
That's the arrows that we're talking about today. And like I said, it's not the be all end all of what you should use to harvest an elk. We want to see some pictures. So you guys send us pictures.
Yep.
info@victoryarchery.com. Send us to them on Facebook, Instagram. We want to see what's going on out there. If you have any questions, comments, let us know. Check us out, www.victoryarchery.com. And like I said, Facebook and Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Yeah, good luck out there.
All right. Have a good one, guys. Thanks.